So this refresher, one part one is basically meant to prepare ourselves for conducting the induction program. So in this workshop, we are going to run the slides which are going to be presented by you to the students during the induction program. And as you have been aware that there are 15 sessions in the induction program, and we'll be running those slides which are to be run in the 15 sessions. So session one essentially is meant for welcoming and introducing the students to each other. So it begins by the introduction. It begins with the introduction of the faculty oneself. So let me say, if I am the faculty conducting the workshop for the students, conducting the program for the students, so I will introduce myself. So if I tell about myself, my name is Kumar Sambhav. I basically belong to Patna, the capital city of Bihar. My educational background was told during the introductory part, so I will not repeat that. Presently, I am teaching at UP Institute of Design, Noida, there as an associate professor, and presently I am also working as head of the department there. If I tell about my family background, so I have my mother and father staying with me. And both are quite appreciative of the program that I'm doing. I have two sisters and one brother. Two sisters are elder to me and brother is younger to me. I have a wife and a girl child. My child is 7 years old. Now, if I talk about some incident from my life or something that I have understood, if we connect to why I volunteered to participate in the UHB session as a co-explorer. So let me say that while studying in class 12 itself, I had some questions regarding understanding of a human being, understanding of the existence. So I had those very questions in me. What am I? Why am I here? Why am I toiling so hard to get into higher studies? What will happen with me? What would be the outcome with all this that I am doing? Those questions were there. So when I came across this content of universal human values, I got satisfied with the response that I got. And I could also see within me through exploration the realities to some extent which were being shared in the workshop. So that motivated me to go ahead. So if you are a faculty there, then you can tell the student that you are going to be there as a co-explorer for the UHB orientation. Okay. And if you are also the mentor for the student, then you can also mention that. And in fact, what we expect from the induction program is that we can be a kind of parent for the student during the stay of the student in the campus throughout. So the students were staying with their parents in their homes, but now they are away from their homes and they are staying in the hostel, okay? And they are going to be there for 2 or 4 years with us. And they need some kind of guidance and care from us. So we ourselves can try to see whether we can be as a parent for the students, at least we can be a mentor for the students. So now, having done this, we can take the introduction of the students. So let's say, as a kind of demonstration, you are a student, okay, and I am the mentor. So I am asking you to introduce yourself. So you can feel as a student for some time and then introduce yourself. So maybe some of you who would like to introduce themselves can raise their hands afresh. Maybe some hands are raised already. But I would request you to raise your hand if you want to introduce yourself as a student. Okay, on these points. Yeah. Dr. Manish, say you are a student and you have to introduce yourself on these lines. So what will you say?
Hello.
Yes.
Good morning. Am I audible?
Yeah, you are audible properly.
Sir, if I am a student, I will introduce myself by saying my name. That is, my name is Manish Sharma. I belong to Nagpur and I have joined here in mechanical engineering one of my hobby or interest that I'm more interested in is the plantation. I believe that the people must plant more and more trees. My family background is my parents, they are staying in Nagpur. My mother is a teacher. My father works as an accountant. I have one sibling, my small sister, younger sister. She is working for a company. Now she is working for a company, sorry. So how we relate to family or society is we all are a part of the society and we need to live in harmony with the society. Aspiration in life is to be more like one should be more respectable in the society by his work rather than his qualification or something. People should more know by the work. This is how I'll try to like introduce myself, sir.
Very nice, sir. In fact, what we expect is that during the induction program, the student should be introducing somebody sitting on his side, right? And so that essentially means that the student has got introduced to the other batchmates.
Other person.
They are introducing each other. Yeah, so that makes the whole atmosphere more harmonious. But in this online session, that is not possible. So nice that you introduced yourself. So let me take another introduction. Mrs. V. Sumati, you can assume for some time that you are a student who has entered into a bachelor's program, okay?
Yes,
so
Bhaiya.
You can think of that stage of life and then introduce yourself.
Yes, Bhaiya. Namaste, Bhaiya. Myself Sumati. I'm from Chennai. I belong to the Department of Mathematics. And my hobby is to solve problems. And my parent, only my mother is along with me. My father is has passed away 10 years before. My siblings, I have four sisters, they have got married. And I have two sons and I'm living, we are in a nuclear family. I'm at Chennai. And aspirations in my life is to be harmony in my life throughout. And expectation from education is I have to learn new things. And I'm a good listener. I want to learn new things from this FDP. And thank you so much for giving me the opportunity as a student.
Nice, Tajidi. Maybe you can revise your introduction so that you can feel yourself to be a student of the first year in bachelor's. So at that time, you did not have a family of your own.
Oh, yes, Bhaiya. Yes, Bhaiya.
So try to do that. Try
yes,
to do
Bhaiya.
That. Can you do that again? Can you introduce yourself again?
Yeah, Bhaiya. I'll be doing. Yes, Bhaiya. Myself, Sumati. I belong to Vilupuram. And I'm doing my BSc Mathematics. My hobby is solving problems, and myself, and what to say, aspiration is in life is being harmony throughout my life, and expectation, I want to clear this UG degree, and I want to study my PG degree, and I want to get a good job.
Nice.
Thank you, Bhaiya. Thanks for the opportunity.
Nice, Didi. Mr. Praveen.
Sir, take yourself, am I audible, sir?
Yeah, take yourself to be a teenager entering into the bachelor's program and then you have to introduce yourself. What were your dreams and imaginations at that stage of life?
Sure, sir. First, I would like to introduce myself as Praveen. I come from Bangalore and as a teenager, I am looking for doing my engineering. I want to pursue my engineering in electronics and communication background. And my hobby is to do to sing. So I'm good at singing. So I would like to be a singer. And my family background is my parents work in a central government organization, and I have one sister who is right now doing her engineering. And I would relate myself that I want to take my family to such a state that after I finish my engineering, and I want to support my family, and I want to be a part of the team and help them. My aspiration in life is to be a successful man with good thoughts. And expectation from education is I am looking for always for a higher education. And education is not at all a it's not ending. So I would always want to study, update myself all the time. So as a teenager, I will always say that I want to learn in multidisciplinary, in all the other backgrounds. I want to go and I want to check how it is. So that is my introduction.
Nice, sir. Dr. Renu, I hope Dr. Garima has spoken otherwise.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Good morning. I am Renu Madhavi. I am from Warangal and I moved to Bangalore. Then I am from Electronics and Instrumentation Engineering Department. And my hobbies are reading books, especially mythological story books. I'm interested in reading them. And then I am from the family of teachers. Both my parents are teachers, and even my sibling, my elder sister is also a government teacher. My younger one is also aspiring to become a teacher. I also want to become a teacher. That's one thing. And then aspirations in the life, I just want to myself to be happy, and I want to make people around me happy, and I want thus make the society happy. And expectation from the education, because we are from the family of teachers, I just want to support my parents by getting a good job, and also try to enhance my knowledge by doing higher education. And I believe in sharing the knowledge and then enhancing the knowledge. That's why I just want to be in the teaching profession, so that I can share my knowledge and then enhance my knowledge. That is what my expectation from my education. Thank you.
Nice, ma'am. I'll take just one more. Dr. Prabhakaran.
Yeah, good morning, Dr. Kumar ji. Thanks for your opportunity given to me to go back to 45 years old back. You know, it's not at all possible, and even Brahma cannot give. You are giving. Thanks. So now my name is S. Prabhakaran. And I am from Mettupalayam, Coimbatore, Tamil Nadu. And I am belong to a normal, a humble agriculture family. And I have joined in the diploma first year, that is in the pre-technical course in the year 1976, right? And my hobby is to cultivate some plants for our home needs. Like small plants and small trees whenever I find time. And also I used to teach my colleagues who are along with me, who are slow learners. That is not because of my habit, but also when I am teaching to them, I am getting refreshed. My memory and this thing is getting replenished. So that is my habit. And about my family members, I have my father, my brother, my mother, and one younger brother, and one elder brother, one elder sister. Relates to family, society. And aspiration in my life is I joined in pre-technical course. After completing the first year, we have got the opportunity of joining engineering degree BE, but I didn't get that seat because of 2 marks less. So my aspiration is to presently complete my diploma, and ultimately in my life I must complete the degree in mechanical engineering, the highest level degree in my life, which I, of course, now I achieved. And my expectation from education, I must get fullest knowledge level, and I must be getting the industrial touch also while I'm doing this diploma, so that when I getting into the industry, the gap between the student and industry expectation will be reduced. That is what I expected. And Mr. Kumar, you are very grateful, and I'm expressing my gratitude because I said I am with my father and mother, but at now both of them are lost. So you made me to recall the old situation where I was living with my father and mother, but now they have passed away. Thank you very much. This is my introduction. Okay.
Thank you, Dr. Prabhakaran.
Yeah.
Nice. We are now feeling ourselves like a student entering into a graduation program and then trying to connect to each other. Very nice, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. So this way we proceed. So in a session, let's say if you are conducting a session and there are 60 students, so this will take, of course, 2 to 3 hours of time. So this is the way the first session goes. And then you give some home assignment. So what is the home assignment here? So get to know as many of your batchmates as you can, and you should be able to introduce at least 5 of them in detail. So in fact, if you see, this induction program is a big help in getting oneself or any student introduced to the whole batch. Generally, this doesn't happen if such a program is not there. I do remember that when I had entered into the BTech program, we had a simple counseling program for 3 days. And there was a very brief introduction in which students who were vocal used to stand up and speak, and I was very shy. So I never stood up and spoke about me. But if you have this kind of induction program, there is a big opportunity that every student, one is shy, one is quite vocal, one is somewhat of a different kind of sanskar, are able to interact with each other. They are able to know how they can relate to each other. So this is one part of the assignment. And then make a list of your aspirations, the expectations of your family and the friends and the hopes you see the nation has from you. So all these have to be listed. In fact, we'll be discussing this in the next session. So this can be given as assignment. So the students have to list their aspirations from life, their aspirations from one themselves, okay? The expectations that they have, the expectations that the family has, okay? And many times you'll see that the expectations of the family may not be in sync with the aspirations of oneself. Many times students do come to the engineering programs, but they want to become a singer, somebody wants to become a cinematographer, somebody wants to become a journalist, but they do come to join the bachelor's program because it is expected from the family. And if these things are not sorted out in the very beginning of the program, then they are not able to do good academically, and then they are cornered during the whole program and they feel at a loss. Okay, while they are able to see that they are not to blame for that. So the hope that they have, and also many times students are not able to see that society also expects something from them. If somebody is coming to join an engineering program, then the society does have some expectation from that student. Nation, the whole world has some expectation because there are so many issues in the society which have to be sorted out with the help of engineering. So that broader perspective can be also brought into picture. And then the students can make a list of their achievements in their life. What have been their achievements? Somebody may say that I qualified for the National Talent Scholarship. Somebody may say that I qualified in some sports activity. Somebody may say that I opened my own YouTube channel and so many people are liking that channel. So many things can be there. So as a student, we can allow them to speak up so that we can see their orientation, their likes and dislikes. Then they can also make a list of their concerns, their fears, the confusion that they carry inside, the question that they have. Okay. So like we'll see that students do have some concerns. Somebody's family may not be having a feeling of prosperity, so they want to earn enough to make their family prosperous. Somebody may have some other aspiration, like after graduating from here, one will be going abroad but he might or she might have a fear that there may be some retardation there. One may not qualify for that. Okay. They might also have some confusions. Maybe when they enter into some engineering department, it may not be of their choice. So how to make a change of the department? Maybe they enter into mechanical engineering and they want to go for computer science. Or they enter into computer science and they want to study physics. This is something that I have also myself observed about several of my batchmates. And then they have some questions regarding the campus, the activities, the programs. So this is an occasion where they can open up. They can openly share all these things that are going on in their imagination. Okay. And then we'll see that if you are able to run this session fruitfully, then it will connect them at a very emotional level to each other. There will be a good kind of binding in the program. So this has to be written in the notebook. So now when we are conducting this in the online session, then we can ask them to list their aspirations, their achievements and concerns. Like this, we can make multiple columns and we can take this data forward in the next session to discuss. So in the next session, we'll explore further into our aspirations and our discuss and also discuss about our concerns. So this happens to be session one. If there are any questions regarding session one, then you can raise your hands. Maybe I'll lower all the hands for once. If there is any doubt or confusion regarding session one, then please let me know. Yeah, Miss Kundri. Miss Kunduri. Yeah, the mic has been offered to you. Dr. Babita. Any question regarding session one, ma'am?
Yes, sir. Sir, when you mentioned the home assignment, you are referring to a UHV note. हम लोग हमेशा से home assignments आप जो एक Google form देते थे FDP में उसमें करते आए हैं. So for this, we are expected to maintain a notebook or something?
If you are doing in the offline mode, then of course the notebook will help. Otherwise, let me go to that slide again. The students will be writing in their own notebook, not okay. As a faculty, the students will be writing in their own notebook all these things, the 4 points that have been listed above, they will be writing for themselves.
Okay, sir.
Mrs. Priya.
Sir, you have written aspirations and expectation in one column, no, but it is two different things.
Yeah, so oblique is given. So many times, no, they are not able to distinguish very clearly what is aspiration and what is expectation. So the expectation can be from somebody else for ourselves, or expectation could be even from my side about myself, that I expect that I will become an IAS officer. Okay, so... And it can also be an aspiration. So both can be listed here. If you can give some other example, I'll try to clarify.
Okay. For example, aspiration. For example, if a student is telling, I want to be a successful civil engineer. Mm-hmm. For then that expectation will be to earn money, no? So it will be in two different columns, no? Why yeah. He wants...
Okay, so that will classify when we go to the next session and we talk about to become something or to do or get something, that will classify there. But here, aspiration could be to become a successful engineer, also to be a wealthy person, to you know, earn enough for myself or even my family or something. So that can be clubbed together here in a single column, and then we can try to distinguish between the two later on. So if I aspire for something, I do expect that it will be accomplished. That's why they have been put in the same column.
Okay, but here you have written two, no, Chahana or Abeksha. So I mean, it is two different entity, no? So that was I was thinking.
Yes, ma'am. So in a similar way, no, like when we make a course, then we try to write the objective of the course and the expected outcome.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So that expected outcome is the expectation and the objective is the aspiration.
Okay, so we can write it in two columns, no, sir? Or for the students?
Okay. You can, ma'am. You can. That you can do. That is possible. Yeah. Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Dr. Rajesh.
Very good morning, sir. Good
morning, sir.
Sir, am I audible, sir?
Not very properly, sir. Hello, sir. Yeah, there is some mingling of sound there. Yeah.
Ah, yes, sir. That is not from my side, sir. Okay, sir. Sir, very thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to participate in this program, sir. Sir, assignment link, how much time it will take, sir? When it will get activated and how much time it will be given, sir, for us? Assignment.
The time that is required is 2 hours, and it is suggested that you complete the assignment between 6 to 8 p.m.
But I okay, think sir. Evening. Get, evening. 6
evening. Yes, sir. Yes. But yes, the sir. Link will get open probably in the post-lunch session, and then will remain open till 9 a.m. tomorrow morning.
Oh, okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Yeah. And it was very interesting, sir. Thank you, sir.
Nice, sir.